What happens now?
We wait for the signal.
What signal?
This meeting can do nothing further to save the country.
That one.
Evening, gentlemen. Shall we be off?
No.
What's the matter?
I have spent today drawn from one bit of madness to another with nothing to show for it. Before I go any further, I would like to know exactly what it is you intend.
Of course. First, we make our way to Nathaniel Bradley's house to fetch the rest of our little group. Then it's on to Griffin's Wharf, where we board the ships and dump the tea. Simple as that.
Simple seems a bit charitable.
Cheer up, Connor. For tonight, we are all victors. The Sons of Liberty get to send a message to England, and you rob William Johnson of his financing. Your village will be saved.
I've an idea. Why don't you lead the way? That should keep us out of any further trouble. Am I right?
Damn it, more guards.
We need to turn the crowd's anger to our advantage.
Say the word, Connor, and I will make it so. We need to keep those bastards at bay while the tea's being dumped.
Let me out. I'm yours to command.
Stop it, please!
We've done it!
Gunner?
We saved the last one for you.
Best we get out of here, huh?
True, but it is hot.
It is done.
Johnson is dead?
No. He retreated when we destroyed the team.
Only to hatch some new scheme, I'm sure. You should have killed him.
There was no need.
Time will tell if you speak the truth.
Radunhagedum!
Ganondokon, why are you here? Has something happened?
William Johnson has returned with all the money required to buy our land. He meets with the elders as we speak. I have begged him to resist, but I fear he shall have his way unless you intervene.
How is this possible? We destroyed the tea.
The Templars are nothing if not resourceful. You should have heeded my warning.
Please, you have to stop him.
Of course. Can you tell me where they're meeting?
Calma.
Not gonna the rod, it canus the ne Johnson's you jot the rocks top. Guahigans, you what neganun hard at Nagedum.
The guater hard at Guacanto.
stop you. You there.
We are not your brothers.
I'll let you
burn you! Be quiet. Land that is not yours nor anything.
I only wish to keep you safe. There are those who would betray and manipulate you. The worst yet is to take the land by force.
We are all fools.
How? By signing our minds over to you? Then we'll be as one in debt forever?
Peace! Peace! Have I not always been an advocate? Have I not always sought to protect you from harm?
If you wish to protect us, then give us arms, muskets and horses that we might defend ourselves.
War is not the answer.
We remember, Stanwix. We remember you moved the borders. Even today your men dig up the land, showing no regard for those who live upon it. Your words are honeyed, but false. We are not here to negotiate, nor to sell. We are here to tell you and yours to leave these lands.
So be it. I offered you an olive branch, and you knocked it from my hand. Perhaps you'll respond better to the sword.
Are you threatening us?
Yes.
Thought you might send one of your own to oppose me? One way is the distance. Now burn.
Call off your dog, or everyone dies!
Oh no. What have you done?
Ensured an end to your schemes. You sought to claim these lands for the Templars.
Aye. That we might protect them. Do you think that good King George lies awake at night, hoping that no harm comes to his native subjects? Or that the people of the city care one whit about them? Oh, sure. The colonists are happy to trade when they need food or shelter, or a bit of extra padding for their armies. But when the walls of the city constrict, when there's crops that need soil, when there's no more enemy to fight, we'll see how kind the people are then.
The colonists have no quarrel with the Iroquois.
Not yet. But they will. This is the way of the world. In time, they'll turn. I could have stopped it. I could have saved you all.
You speak of salvation, but you were killing them.
Aye. Because they would not listen. And so, it seems, neither will you.
Ayamas ne yahte hagum sare am dahyayum ne skana se zagum haje.
I'll only tell you again.
Come on, then.
Take it, boys. We'll get him.
None of your life.
You fight a tomato, Daddy.
Are you?
William Johnson is dead, and with him, the Templar plot to steal the land of my people. But in ending this threat, I have revealed another. On his body was a letter addressed to John Pitcairn containing orders to root out and destroy Patriot weapons and supplies. Should he succeed in this, the colonists will be unable to maintain their resistance, and the Templars will surely take control. So long as Pitcairn lives, the danger remains. I need to find him. He needs to die. I thought it might bring clarity or instill a sense of accomplishment, but all I feel is regret.
Hold fast to that. Such sacrifices must never come lightly.
I had to do it. Not only for my people, but for all the others Johnson would have harmed.
It's a start. But to truly be free of Templar influence, all of them must be dealt with in turn. Even your father.
I know.
You speak the words, but do you believe them? Seems we've company.
What is it?
A request for aid from Paul Revere. Seems the Redcoats are up to something in Boston. Guess you made an impression on the Sons of Liberty.
They mistake me for one of their own. Please tell Mr. Revere he has my sympathies, but I cannot help at present.
You might wish to reconsider. John Pitcairn is mentioned by name.
Where am I to go?
Mr. Revere's house in Boston. If you'd like, I can...
They even speak to our clients. I need some help here.
Richard, turnips, cauliflower.
Empty that purse.
God forsaken thumb.
Piss off. You want to catch a beating? Get close.
Keep moving, mate.
Connor, what a relief. You came. Allow me to introduce you to William Dawes and Robert Newman.
Your letter said John Pitcairn was here.
Aye. He's readying an assault on Lexington, where Adams and Hancock have taken shelter. After that, he will march on Concord, hoping to destroy our weapons and supplies. You must help us.
Only tell me where to find him, and I will put a stop to this.
He has dozens, if not hundreds, of soldiers at his command. You cannot hope to match him by yourself. But fear not, for you will not have to. We have an entire army of our own, merely awaiting the order to take up arms.
Then you must call upon them.
Indeed. You and I cross the Charles River and rouse the boys. William, I need you to take the overland route and do the same. Robert, I need you up in Christchurch. Light the signal. Two lanterns, our enemy comes by sea.
No time for dawdling, my friend. We have lives to save. Come on.
They've only left a single horse. We'll have to ride together. You take the reins, I'll navigate. Quickly, Connor, get on the horse! I'll guide you towards those we need to alert. Follow my directions, and we'll be done in no time.
Yes! This is it! This is the way! Redcoats. What are they doing here?
They must be scouts.
Be careful, Connor. We mustn't let them warn the others. Go left up here. Might be safer if we approach the houses on foot. This is it! You have got the right place! Let everyone know that the regulars marched for Lexington and Concord!
The British are coming!
Back in the saddle, my friend! We have more people to warn! This is it! This is the way! Keep going! Excellent! We are right on course! Yes, this is exactly where we need to be! This way, Connor! Keep going! Keep going! Be on the lookout for redcoats. Keep going! Keep going! To the right! Turn right! Let us continue the search on foot. Be on the lookout for redcoats. This is it! You have got the right place! Spread the word. The regulars are coming out.
At once!
Go right, Connor. Where are we? This is all wrong. Might be safer if we approach the houses on foot. This is it!
You have got the right place. The regulars are coming.
Here. We're here. Get them!
We need to lose them. We need to lose them.
I have got you!
Well, I suppose this gives you the element of surprise. To lose them.
Stop running!
Find a way to get rid of them, Connor.
Any last word?
Find a way to get rid of them, Connor. That's one way to deal with the situation. That was much too close for comfort. Let us take care to avoid any further surprises. We will never finish in time if we go by foot. Is everything all right, my friend? We will never finish in time if we go by foot. Get back on the horse, Connor. This is it. You have got the right place. Where the devil is he?
Are you sure we are in the right place?
Well, sure, I'm sure. Prescott?
Evening, gents.
Listen, the regulars are out. You need to rally your men. And, put on some trousers.
At once.
Welcome to Lexington, Connor. Now let's find Hancock and Adams. No sign of Dawes. I hope he's all right.
Paul, Connor, good to see you.
You need to leave. The Redcoats are coming.
Aye, so Williams told us. Let them conduct their little search. They'll find nothing.
You don't understand. Pitcairn intends to kill you.
I'm afraid it's true.
I suppose we have no choice then but to go. What of you three?
Dawes and I will continue on to Concord. Connor, it's best you stay here and help our man John Parker hold the town. It'll give us time to spread the word.